answers. Though all her relatives and friends were perfect dancers, she swore she'd never dance a step until she died. She said, I've seen too many movies, and all they prove is too idiotic. They all insist that South America's exotic. It couldn't be more boring if it tried. Miranda was subversive propaganda and should rapidly be shot. She said she didn't give a jot if people quoted her or not. She refused to begin the begin when they requested it. And she made an embarrassing scene if anyone requested it. They proposed to her, she simply left it flat. She said that love should be impulsive, but not convulsive, and syncopation has a discouraging effect on procreation, and that she'd rather read a book, and that was that. Of her relations who did the conga and swore that if she had to stand it any longer, she'd lose all dignity and wring their silly necks. She said that frankly she was blinded to all their over-advertised romantic charms, and then she got more bloody-minded and told them where to put their tropic palms. To be pedantic, but I'm driven nearly frantic when I see that unromantic, sycophantic lot of sluts forever wriggling their guts. It drives me absolutely nuts. She declined to begin the begin, though they besought her to. And in language profane and obscene, she cursed the man who taught her to. She cursed cold porter to. Fairly clear that Nina, in her demeanor, was so offensive that when the hatred of her friends grew too intensive, she thought she'd better beat it while she had the chance. After some trial and tribulation, she reached the station and met a sailor who had acquired a wooden leg in Venezuela, and so she married him because he couldn't dance. There surely never could have been a Bambina, who had the luck to find Romana.